A heart is such an iconic shape. How many times have you seen one? I've certainly lost count. It's typically a daily occurrence. And yet, when I created the fourth free hype template, it was like seeing a heart for the first time. It's true. I could not believe that I could make a perfectly shaped heart with two circles and a rotated square. That's the purpose of the heart template. It animates the merger of simple shapes to make something new. Let's start there. In the heart template, you can see the three shapes. One rectangle, and two ellipses. The rectangle is actually a square, and the ellipses are perfect circles. This is a good first project to learn how hype animation works. Only the location of the elements are changed. The rectangle moves up and down, while the circles move towards and away from the square. You can get a better understanding of what's going on by looking at the properties. The origin is being modified. In other words, the left and top positions are changed. This is how hype's keyframe animation works. You pick a starting point, and then you pick an ending point. That's what I love about this template. It's a simple way to explain how things work. Look closer. Do you see the metrics pane? The numbers change as I move the timeline cursor. Now let's be real. Hype has been around for a few years. If you're watching this video right now, odds are you know how to use a timeline. So let's do something new. It starts with some interesting words from Photics.com. Back in 2016, the following message was written. Technology moves fast. If Tumult adds an SVG editor and more Matter.js features to Hype, there could be another way to create a heart. Well, that's exactly what they did. They added a scalable vector graphics editor to Hype. So let's look at another way to create a heart with the vector shape tool. Before adding points, the Snap Elements and Points option is unchecked. This part is very precise, so we don't want our points to be forced into nearest neighbor locations. On this channel, the philosophy is to teach designers to code. However, the reverse is true too, teaching coders to design and draw. We've heard the phrase learn to code. Well, you can learn to draw too. And if you don't know how to draw, that's okay. We can start by tracing the heart. First, zoom in real close. This is not going to be exact, so the closer you go, the better you can hide the imperfections. Start by adding a point at the bottom of the heart, and then just go around the heart, adding points at the extreme edges. The fewer points used, the better. This will keep the artwork lightweight and be less demanding on the CPUs of your website visitors. So okay, we have what looks like the Tesla Cybertruck version of a heart. Don't worry. This is not a stainless steel heart. We can easily round those edges. Just grab the center of a line and then pull it outward. This adds an anchor point with handlebars. Since this is a vector shape, we can control the shape of the curve. Just make adjustments until your vector shape closely aligns with the heart. Repeat this process until your vector shape matches the shape of the heart. Changing the background color of your shape can help. You don't want your lines to be too close or too far from the edges of the heart. Turning off the border helps too. That way, you can be more precise. Now, I like to code, but sometimes it's just so frustrating, the endless puzzles. A project like this is a nice way to relax. It's peaceful. You're just adding happy little points until what you're imagining becomes real. Let's move this shape into its own scene. Since it's a vector shape, the heart is infinitely scalable. Make it as big or as small as you want. Well, within reason, obviously. Once you have your heart as a vector shape, there is so much you can do. As an example, you can animate the border with the line draw option. See? Isn't that awesome? You might have noticed that the edges are a little too sharp. No problem. You can fix that with the line join option. There is a round setting. That should smooth things out. Adjusting the points can help too. This is only a starting point. You can be creative and create your own custom heart. You're not limited to tracing. But here's the real mind-exploding stuff. You can animate the shape. Here's how that works. First, hit the record button and then move the timeline cursor to the right. A few seconds should be fine. Then, start deleting points. Seriously, this works. Let's make the heart a square. I haven't seen shape morphing on the web since the heydays of Flash. It's nice to see a return of this feature. Just remember not to go too crazy. This can be a very processor-intensive task. But here's the best part. Now that you have a vector shape, this can be converted into a physics object, with a custom collision shape. That's just crazy powerful. We started this project with two circles and a square. They teamed up to form a heart. Now, a single square turns into a heart. Both are fine examples of how you can add animation to your website with hype. Did you like this fun little project? You can let me know in the comments. Feedback can help morph the shape of this channel. Future hype videos, and lots of other videos, are planned for Photics TV. And if you want to learn more about hype, you might like a book about hype, as it's loaded with lots of useful information, similar to what was shown here.